Hello students, welcome to our class. We have been discussing about acids and bases and properties of acids and bases. Yes, here in this session we are going to be learn what is the reaction of acids and bases with metals. So let me see that. Here, reaction of acids and bases with metals. Yes, today we are going to learn about this topic. So, when acid react with metal or base react with metal, what do we obtain? In the chemical reaction, what products we will obtain? Yes, let me discuss in this session. So now, for this lab activity, we should take some operators, means some materials which required for the activity. Yes, what are those? First aim, what is the aim of us? Yes, to find out what is the action and reaction of the chemical process in this activity. Means nothing but acids when react with the metals or base react with metal, what product we are going to obtain. So we will observe here. This is the aim. And what is the material required? Yes, material required. We have to take the materials, which is this retort stand, test tube, and delivery tube, one glass trough, next zinc hydrochloric acid, zinc granules. So these are things required materials for this lab activity. Next, how do we do the procedure? Yes, we have to fix the test tube to the retort stand, and we have to add some dilute hydrochloric acid to it. Next, we should add zinc granules in there. After then, we should close the test tube by using cork, rubber cork. Yes. After completion of this, we have to insert the delivery tube through the cork in a test tube. Yes. After other end of the delivery tube, we have to be place the in a glass trough. Yes, which is contained soap solution. Yes, this is the required materials and arrangement of the materials. Next, what do we observe? Yes, by this reaction, by this activity, what do we observe? Yes, we observe that hydrochloric acid react with zinc granules and form the zinc chloride and hydrogen gas. Yes. Then we can observe this hydrogen gas by bringing the burning matchstick near to the mouth of the glass trough. Then that matchstick will burn with the pop sound. So we can identify that releasing gas is hydrogen gas. Yes, we have already discussed in this concept in the chemical reaction. Yes, here. Then finally, what do we interference about this equation? Yes, let me see that. So here, how do we show this equation in the form of symbol? Yes. Then what is that? Zinc react with hydrochloric acid and gives rise to zinc chloride and hydrogen gas. Yes. Is it balanced? No. So let me write 2 here. Yes. Then it is balanced equation now. So if acids or base react with metals, then same hydrogen gas release and related salt will be obtained in the conical flask or beaker, whatever we take in the procedure. Yes. If we take the zinc granule and sodium hydroxide, then what will be obtained? Yes. Yes, sodium zincate. This is the salt and hydrogen gas liberate. So check it here. 2 hydrogens means we have to write 2 here. So this is the balanced equation. Now we can observe that when the acid react with metal or base react with metal, it forms the related salt and hydrogen gas. Yes, hydrogen gas liberate. So we can understand by this session when the metals reacted with acid and bases are When the acids or bases react with metal, it forms the related salts and hydrogen gas. So, students, I hope you understand this session and you write the equation of this activity and you observe the procedure of this activity. The reaction of acids with metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates. Yes, so let me see that in this session. Here, to know the procedure of reaction of acid with metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates, we need some steps. Yes, what are those? A, material required and procedure, what is the observation and what is the final conclusion? Yes, let me see that. So, what is the aim? To check when the acid react with metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates, what product obtained? Yes, our aim is that. Next, material required. What are the materials required for this procedure? Yes, here we should take a retort stand and test tubes. Yes, 2-3 test tubes we should take. And sodium hydrogen carbonate, yes, and sodium carbonate solution, nothing but salt, these are the salts. Sodium carbonate is a salt and sodium hydrogen carbonate also salt, yes. So we should take that and for delivery tube and thistle funnel we should take for this activity. These are the materials which are required, yes. Next, what is the procedure? How do we do the procedure? So, for the procedure, we should start, we should take the test tube and we should fix the test tube to the retort stand. After that, we should add hydrochloric acid in the test tube and next we should add sodium carbonate, sodium carbonate salt, yes, for some amount of sodium carbonate salt. When we add, after adding this one, then we should close with rubber cap and through the rubber cap we should insert a one thistle funnel and we should insert the delivery tube from the rubber cap. Yes, through the rubber cap. Yes. Then this delivery tube, another end is we have to insert in the another test tube which is contained lime water, nothing but calcium hydroxide. So then what we will observe? Yes, this hydrochloric acid react with sodium carbonate, whatever we taken in the first test tube. Yes, those sodium carbonate react with hydrochloric acid and it gives the respective salt and water molecule and carbon dioxide gas. Yes, carbon dioxide gas evolved from this reaction. So, this evolved gas pass through the delivery tube and enter into the another test tube. Yes. So, what will be present in another test tube? Yes, lime water will be present. So, this carbon dioxide gas react with lime water and change the lime water into milky white color. Yes. Before adding the carbon dioxide gas, that lime water is in dull white. After when the carbon dioxide enter into the test tube, then this carbon dioxide change the lime water into milky white color. Yes, by this observation we can conclude that in this reaction carbon dioxide gas is evolved. Yes, so let me show this procedure in the form of equation. Yes, when the hydrochloric acid react with sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, sodium carbonate formula, then it forms the respective salt, NaCl, sodium chloride, and water molecules, carbon dioxide gas. Yes. And same thing, instead of sodium carbonate, if we take the sodium hydrogen carbonate, same reaction will be takes place. So, when the acid react with the sodium hydrogen carbonate, it gives the respective salt and water molecule and carbon dioxide gas. Yes. Then, when carbon dioxide gas pass through the delivery tube and enter into the another test tube which contain lime water, then what reaction will be takes place? Let me see that. So, carbon dioxide when pass into the lime water, then this is the calcium hydroxide, nothing but lime water. Yes, what is this? Lime water. So, when carbon dioxide gas enter into the lime water, it change into milky white color. This is the precipitate, calcium carbonate. And water molecule will form. So this is the entire procedure which is we can show in the form of equation. So here students, you have to understand and you have to show the procedure, entire procedure in the form of equation. So what did we conclude here? Yes, what can we conclude and what can we observe here means in this reaction, when the acid react with the carbonates, means metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates, then carbon dioxide gas will evolve from the reaction. So here this is the procedure of this reaction. Students, I hope you understand this session and you must practice these equations of the reaction. So thank you.